and welcome to Environmental Education. I'm your host, Christina Moffitt.
And I'm your co-host, Sean Gerhard.
We're here to teach you new ways to live a sustainable lifestyle. But first, we'd like to talk about what got us interested in protecting our environment. Why don't you start?
So for me, one of the requirements here at Mom is that you have to take a science class. So I decided to take my climate science class. And it's become my favorite class here at Monmouth. The professor's new here. She makes the lectures very interesting. So I kind of just, like, it made me realize how important this actually is. And that's kind of, it's kind of a new interest for me. It's something I haven't really been, you know, focused on in the past until this semester.
What kind of topics have you talked about in class?
So she doesn't go over, like, politics. It's more of just strictly the science.
Okay.
So we just learned about La Nina and El Nino.
Okay.
We learned about the Coriolis effect and how the Earth is warmed through wind and such like that. And we're learning about how the ocean's acidifying. I don't even know if that's a word, acidifying, but it's strictly the science stuff.
Okay.
The class doesn't focus on, like, policies or anything like that.
That sounds really interesting. I'll have to look into taking that.
It's a level 100 class.
Oh, okay.
It's new. They're offering more sections next year, too. So if anyone's interested in it, I definitely recommend taking it.
Sounds good. And tell them what your major is.
Oh, so my major is radio and TV. Hey, that's why I'm here. With a minor in sports communication. But I'm looking for a second minor right now. And I've actually thought about taking global sustainability as a minor now, just because of this class. So we'll see. And like I said, maybe this will relate to what I do in the future. Even it is all of our responsibility to know what our Earth is. So even if it doesn't, I feel like all people should take a class like this.
Yeah, definitely. That's really interesting.
What about you, Christina?
So my major is also communication, radio, and TV. And pretty much I've always been interested in the environment. I'm constantly learning more and more about it. But when I was younger, I was always interested in, like, Earth Day. Like, oh, like, let's go plant something. And then I think it was, like, Nickelodeon did something where at this time you turn off all the electric in your house. So I, like, made my family do it. And we, like, went outside and, like, we're seeing if anyone else was doing it. No one was. But I was just, like, really excited. Like, oh, my gosh, it's so cool that if everybody, you know, turns off their electric for a minute, like, it's saving energy and different things like that. And I've always been interested in, like, recycling different things and making them into crafts. My grandma got me into things like that. She would make things out of old light bulbs, like snowmen. She was really artistic. So I think I've always had an interest in environmental issues. And then last semester, I studied abroad in Australia. And they are a lot more conscious.
Let's move on with it.
Yeah.
We're comm majors. We don't know anything.
Yeah, we don't know what it is. But they're a lot more environmentally aware, I'll say that, than we are here. So I think that impacted my decisions a lot. I purchased all reusable bags once I got there and kind of started making my grocery shopping without using plastic. So I would get the broccoli that's just sitting out, and I wouldn't put it into a plastic bag, or I'd buy the potatoes that aren't bagged. Because you're going to wash it anyway. Why does it need to be in plastic? So also, the two girls I studied abroad with have an interest in the environment. And they also persuaded me into, like, getting into it. And we went to a movie premiere. It was an environmental showing. And this girl, Plastic Mermaid, who's famous on Instagram for avoiding single-use plastics, she was there to talk about it. And I just found it really interesting, and it's just gotten me really into it now that I make sure I carry my reusable bags with me everywhere. And I'm using a reusable water bottle now, opposed to plastic bottles. So I'm just trying to, like, learn new ways of trying to make a difference, I guess.
So besides the reusable bag, what did you see at your time abroad in Australia that, you know, maybe we could carry over here to the U.S.?
Yeah, so some things I saw were, like, at the beaches, sometimes they have drains that, like, lead water into it. They have nets over them that collects the trash so that it doesn't go into the ocean water, which I thought was really cool. I also noticed that everywhere you go, you have to pay extra for plastic bags, similar to some stores around us. But, you know, many stores you go to, you just naturally get a plastic bag for free. But there it's like 50 cents or 30 cents per plastic bag you get. So it just ends up being cheaper to purchase a reusable bag and, you know, bring it back with you over and over again. So I think that made a really big transition for people because you don't want to pay for a plastic bag, yeah. You know? They just accumulate and you have so many. You can just have one reusable bag or two, however many you need for your groceries. It just ends up being cheaper. And even things like little ketchup packets that you get when you go get fast food, you have to pay extra for each one of them, which is crazy to me.
That's a smart idea, though. And I know at home in Ocean County, New Jersey, they are starting to ban plastic bags and putting a tax on it, like you were saying. I believe it's at 10 cents right now. I'm not sure what that number is on the top of my head, though.
Yeah. And I think that's a great way of, you know, cutting down plastic use. And Australia is working to ban plastic bags. I believe it's New South Wales, where I was, is the only territory left to ban plastic bags. I'm not positive on that, though. But even to-go boxes, you know, like the styrofoam containers, I had to pay extra at places for them, too. So it's just something to think about, like some ways that we could, you know, try to push people into doing certain things that also protects the environment.
It's crazy how much the small stuff really makes a difference. First off, we wanted to start off with describing exactly what an environment is, though, for everybody.
So according to What is the Environment on FactMonster.com, the environment is described as everything that makes up our surroundings and affects our ability to live on Earth.
This includes air we breathe, the water that covers most of the Earth's surface, the plants and animals around us, and more.
So here's a timeline of our environment.
The reactor core at the Three Mile Island nuclear power plant in Pennsylvania partially melts down, releasing radiation into the surrounding communities. It will take more than 10 years to clean up fully.
In 1988, NASA scientist James Hansen warns Congress about the consequences of global warming and argues that the ozone layer is eroding much faster than was predicted.
And in 1989, the Exxon Valdez tanker runs onto a reef in Alaska's Prince William Sound, dumping 76,000 tons of crude oil. The spill, the largest ever in the United States, covers more than 5,100 kilometers of pristine coastline with oil and kills more than 250,000 birds.
In 1993, the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency and the U.S. National Academy of Sciences release reports concluding that the buildup of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases in the Earth's atmosphere will likely lead to global warming.
And in 2001, the IPCC releases a report citing new and stronger evidence that most of the observed warming of the last 50 years is attributable to human activities. The study projects that at current rates, temperatures will increase by 1.4 to 5.8 degrees Celsius by 2100.
In 2002, half of North America's most biodiverse regions are degraded, and 235 mammal, reptile, bird, and amphibian species are now threatened.
According to environmentamerica.org, some 2019 federal priorities include climate change and renewable energy, conservation, and investing in clean water.
This timeline focuses on large events that occurred in the United States, but there have been countless events that have taken place that we didn't mention.
It does not include all the great initiatives that have been created and implanted, but there is still more that we need to do.
I really can't believe all the events that have occurred in our environment. I don't know about you.
And this is just the surface of the problems. I mean, that's just a quick read through of them. It's just so much that we do harms our environment.
Yeah, and this timeline only focuses on the United States. So, I mean, for the most part, but just think about, you know, the whole world, what every different country is doing and how it affects our planet. It's just crazy to think about for me.
Yeah, I mean, it's like I keep saying, it affects everybody and everyone should learn about it. And there's so many things that we need to do as a species, humans, what we need to do in order to fix these problems that we've caused.
Yeah.
It's too late for some of them, it's too late to fix.
Yeah, and the thing we were talking about earlier was that I think once people start learning almost about environmental issues, they just become attached to it because it's so important and it's so informative. And, you know, just having this education makes you want to learn more and get involved in this initiative to protect our environment. So I think it's kind of just like almost addictive, like to learn more about it.
Well, it's scary.
It is.
For me, it was a fear factor kind of thing. Like when my teacher started class saying, oh yeah, I moved from California because it's going to be total flames year round by 2050. And I'm like, well, that doesn't sound good.
No, it doesn't. You know?
So I, for me, it was a fear factor thing. But yeah.
It's really something to think about, you know. And I think a lot of people, it is maybe that fear thing too. I don't really know what it was for me. I guess it was just kind of the interest was there. I actually, you know what? I think I watched, it was Al Gore, one of his presentations. And I also love animals. So I think just seeing, you know, like animals lose their like habitats and things like that, it's just really upsetting to me. So maybe it's like an emotional connection I have.
Some kind of attachment to it. Yeah. Get you hooked in, you know?
Yeah. And, you know, there's just so much to learn about it. So I guess that's why I was mostly interested. So we'll be right back after a quick commercial break, and stay tuned for an environmental trivia game show up next. Welcome to our environmental trivia game show. We're here with our two contestants, Bruce Davis and Shantae James. Thank you guys for joining us.
No problem.
No problem at all.
So why don't you guys introduce yourselves?
I'm Shantae. I'm a biology major. I like the environment, so.
Also my roommate.
Yes, she's my roommate. She dragged me here.
Yeah. All right, you didn't have to say that.
All right. Bruce Davis. I am a junior. I'm a Homeland Security major, and I'm here to win. I'm here to win.
All right.
Yeah.
So in total, you guys will be asked 9 questions, and you'll have 10 seconds to answer each question to prove who knows more environmental facts. Sean is going to be taking points off camera, and once I finish reading the question and possible answers, the timer will begin. Do you guys have any questions for me?
Nope.
Let's get started.
So once I read the first question, so you guys can see on their laps, they have something facing down. Once I read the first question, they can flip it over. And once the timer goes off, they have to throw up their answer of A, B, C, or D. So how are you feeling?
I'm a little nervous, but I'm ready.
Same. I think I'm a little.
I'm a little nervous.
All right. Here we go. Question 1. What was Earth's warmest year on record? Is it A, 2004, B, 2018, C, 2009, or D, 2016?
Jesus.
Pull up an answer. What do we have?
B.
B and B. Well, you answered B, 2018. The correct answer was D, 2016.
It's not a good start.
No.
It's not a good start, but we're working.
According to NASA, National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, scientists said that 2016 was the warmest year to date. This is due to El Nino or La Nina, which warm upper tropical Pacific Ocean, which causes wind and global patterns that can affect global average temperature.
That was good to know.
Yep.
There you go. Not off to a good start, guys.
It's all right. No. Listen, we still all right. Got 8 more.
On to question number 2. How many pounds of garbage does the average American produce daily? A, 4.4 pounds. B, 5.7 pounds, C, 3.2 pounds, or D, 6.8 pounds. D. The correct answer was A.
What?
4.4 pounds.
Oh, God.
According to the Environmental Protection Agency, Americans generated about 251 million tons of trash in 2012. That is only for the U.S. alone. So imagine how much trash is generated on Earth.
Well, these all loose together.
I'm sorry, Earth. I'm sorry.
All right, on to question three. What is the ozone layer? A, the top of the top layer of the ocean. B, the layer around the equator. C, the layer of protective gases that shield Earth from radiation. Or D, the layer of atmospheric gases that surround the sun.
Confident.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm confident in this one. If I get this wrong, it's over.
What do we have? You're both correct.
Yay.
The layer of protective gases that shields the Earth from harmful radiation.
That's what I like.
Consider the ozone as a sponge. According to the National Geographic, the ozone layer absorbs some of the radiation hitting Earth from the sun. We do need radiation to survive, but too much of it can be damaging. Unfortunately, our ozone layer is thinning, and a reason could be due to chemicals like aerosol sprays. All right. And on to question number four. How much water does the average American use every day? Is it A, 75 gallons, B, 150 gallons, C, 90 gallons, or D, 100 gallons? We have A and C. The correct answer was D, 100 gallons.
Yo, that's
according to the United States Geological Survey, the largest use of household water is when an individual flushes the toilet, then afterwards to take a shower and bath.
Oh, gosh.
100 gallons?
100 gallons every day. Are you surprised?
Yes.
Yes, that's a lot of water.
Exactly.
Doesn't that make you...
That's a lot of water.
I mean, but we gotta flush the toilet.
Wanna conserve some of your water?
I'm still supposed to flush.
Hey, there's other ways. All right, so on to question five. How much are scientists predicting the seas will rise by the end of this century? A, 26 inches, B, 35 inches, C, 32 inches, and D, 29 inches. A and D. The correct answer was A, 26 inches.
That's a winner right there. That's a winner.
According to a 25-year based study by NASA and European satellite data, sea levels are rising faster than believed. Greenhouse gases cause the Earth's air and water temperature to rise, resulting in water expanding and ice caps to melt. All right, so on to question six. What year did the United States EPA declare greenhouse gases a threat to public health? The correct answer is C, 2009.
Yes, yes.
That makes sense.
So we are going to take a quick break, and we will finish the game after the break and announce our winner of this week's trivia game show. Stay tuned.
Talk TV News, and we've got it covered. This is Hawk TV News.
This is Hawk TV News, and we've got it covered.
Welcome back to our environmental trivia game show. We are going to get right back into the swing of things and finish off our game. We have three questions left. I'm here with Shantae and Bruce. And let's finish off our game, guys.
Ready to do it.
Let's get to
it.
All right. Right on to question number 7. The melting of the Greenland ice sheet poses an immediate threat to the survival of which animal? Is it A, polar bears, B, Arctic foxes, C, walruses, or D, harp seals?
I'm gonna go with the only one I ever heard about, honestly.
Yeah.
Congrats, you are both correct. Yay. Polar bears. According to National Geographic, Greenland's glaciers are melting 4 times faster than believed. Between 2002 and 2016, Greenland lost approximately 280 billion tons of ice per year. This average annual ice melt is enough to cover the entire states of Florida and New York hip deep in meltwater, as well as drowning Washington, D.C., and 1 or 2 other small states.
Wow. Yikes.
We need to get together.
That's a lot of water.
All right, so on to question number 8. What percentage of our air pollution comes from motor vehicles like cars and trucks? A, 50%, B, 25%, C, 75%, or D, 60%?
Okay. That was a little quick.
All right, we have A and C. The correct answer is C, 75%. According to the Environmental Protection Agency, emissions from cars increase the levels of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. Many scientists believe that burning fossil fuels, such as gasoline, causes greenhouse gas levels to spike, leading to global warming. All right, guys. You guys ready for our last question?
I'm ready.
All right. Question 9 and the final one. Every year, blank acres of the rainforest are gone forever. Is it A, 17.7 million, B, 18.7 million, C, 19.2 million, or D, 21.3 million? Make your best guess.
Yep.
Here we
drastic.
Go. Eeny, meeny, miny.
The correct answer is B, 18.7 million. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo coming
in. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo.
There you go.
It never failed.
Oh, man.
It worked out. According to the World Wildlife Fund, deforestation comes in many forms, including fires, clear cutting for agriculture, ranching and development, unsustainable logging for timber, and degradation due to climate change, which impacts people's livelihoods and threatens a wide range of plant and animal species. All right, so we have Sean here, ready to announce our winner.
So, I have our final count. It was not a close race. I'll just tell you that right now. And Bruce, you were the winner.
Thank you very much, sir.
Congratulations, man.
Thank you for participating.
Congrats,
you're welcome, Bruce.
You're welcome. As your prize, you receive a Hawk TV reusable bag.
Oh, wow. Thank you. I will be reusing this.
I'm very happy to hear that.
It's style. You go with blue, man.
Yeah, it matches.
So I had to be the winner today. That's what that meant. That means I came
Shantae has blue on, too. So,
but I won.
I guess it just wasn't Shantae's lucky.
No, it was not.
Next time.
Yeah, you got them next time.
We'll see.
Honestly, most of these was guesses anyway, but I'm glad I learned something, to be honest.
There you go.
I learned a lot.
Guesses. That's what the show is about. It's all about learning. So what we wanted to do was present an eco-friendly tip of the week, and this week's is to save water.
So the first thing you do is if you shorten your shower by just a minute or two, you'll save up to 150 gallons per month.
Tip number two, if you turn off the water while you brush your teeth, you can save up to 4 gallons a minute. That's up to 200 gallons a week for a family of four.
Tip number three, designate one glass for your drinking water each day or refill a water bottle. This will cut down on the number of glasses to wash.
Tip number four, keep a pitcher of drinking water in the refrigerator instead of running the tap. This way, every drop goes down you and not the drain. What do you guys think about those facts?
It's crazy.
Think you can implement them?
Yeah, the little things can save so much.
Yeah, I think I like the pitcher idea, filling up a pitcher. I've seen a couple people do that, but I think I'll try that out.
Yeah.
That's gonna be
I actually got in our apartment, I got a Brita filter pitcher.
Yep.
And just run the tap water in it, and it filters it out, and just keep it in the fridge.
Yep.
And also, reusable bottles help a lot, too, with avoiding plastic. I know I converted Shantae into doing that. I pretty much said, hey, I found this bottle on Amazon.
You should get it.
Okay. I'm ordering it for you. You can give me the money. And she's been using it. So, hey, and it also prevents you from having to carry up a case of water up your stairs your room.
That's also true.
That was the most convincing factor.
Not fun doing freshman year, not having an elevator.
Oh, that was terrible.
Carrying it up flights of stairs, that's definitely not fun.
Yep. Well, my dad did it, so I didn't really have to do it.
All right, well, that works too, I guess. But let's save the environment. But thank you guys so much for being on our show.
No problem.
Really appreciate
it. No problem at all. This has been a new experience for me. I'm not even gonna. This is pretty cool. I didn't know that our impact was this big, and now that I do, I'm gonna change a couple things.
Good. I'm glad to hear that. How about you, Shantae?
Well, I knew it was this big, and I've been trying to like do what I can, and convincing my family too, which is very hard because you know it doesn't impact them now, so they don't really hear. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How about you, Sean? How do you feel about these questions and how it impacts the world? Do you think you're going to make some changes yourself?
I'm going to make some changes, definitely. I think a problem like this affects everybody, so it's a responsibility of everybody to make these changes. And you know, presenting these in a fun way will hopefully teach people a better way of becoming more aware of their environment.
Definitely, I agree. Well, thank you guys so much for being on, and we hope to see you soon on Environmental Education. I'm your host, Christina Moffitt.
And I'm Sean Gerhard.
Thanks for watching.
Sure, I look cute now, but when my owner lost his job, it was rough. I was living on the street, and one night, me and this Cocker Spaniel got into it so bad, I wound up looking like an ice cream cone. I cried a little bit, but thankfully I got rescued, so I'm running, I'm jumping, all back to my old self, and I'm ready to give unconditional love, even if you put a lampshade on my head.
Is a show that me and my two great friends produce. It's a show about where we talk about entertainment. People call us the entertainment show. We have one segment about movies, one segment about TV, and we have one segment about music. Literally whatever you want to do, you do it. If you mess up, you mess up. That's what this is for.